Hello and welcome. My name's George, and my channel is all about helping you get the most out of Logic Pro so that you can record and produce your best music in your home studio. Today, we're going to be looking at flex time. We'll take a look at the different modes and algorithms that you'll find within flex time, and I'll show you when to apply these to the different material that you'll be using flex time on. So let's dive in. So the first thing to access flex time is you want to go up here to this button here that says Show Hide Flex. So you can either click on that or the shortcut key is Command F. Now once you've clicked the flex button, then you'll see this other flex button appear here on your actual track. And so the next step is to actually enable flex on the individual tracks. So right now, currently flex is turned off on these tracks. So all we got to do is click the on button here. And then you saw that the first time that you enable flex on a track, Logic will analyze that track for the transients. And it'll also automatically select the algorithm that Logic thinks is the most appropriate for this material. So right now you'll see here it says polyphonic. And if I click on this menu, then I can switch that to the different algorithms that we have here. So I'm going to go through the different algorithms and explain when it would be the best time to use those. So starting with monophonic. So monophonic is best used on monophonic instruments. So an instrument where you'd be playing just one note at a time, so no chords involved. So the most likely instrument for that would be the bass, for example. Let's go find our bass. So I'll turn this on, and we have this set to monophonic. So if I zoom in on my bass, you see that Logic analyzed all the transients, and it's put these little dotted lines where it thinks each note is starting. If I zoom in a little bit more, you can see that. So right now, there's been no time stretching or anything applied yet to this bass. So a couple options we can do is we can actually get Logic to quantize it on its own. And to do that, you simply select the region that you want to quantize. So I have my bass highlighted right now. And then I would go to region up here, hit the little arrow, and where it says quantize, you would select a value there. So if I wanted to quantize to the nearest eighth note, I can select eighth notes. And then you saw how each of these notes shifted a little bit. And you'll also notice the colors changed a bit. So some are white, some are gray, some are blue. So the blue notes are relatively unchanged. And then the gray and white are stretched and shortened. So doing this, Logic automatically kind of placed our bass track on the grid. Now, if we want to just manually do a few tweaks, we could turn off that quantize altogether and start from scratch, or we could just make a few tweaks to what we have already. So I'm just going to go ahead and turn off the quantize for now. And let's say I just wanted to move this one note over. If I simply click on this dotted line, it'll create a flex marker here. And now if I click and drag, it'll move everything afterwards, that flex marker. So now I not only moved this one note that I wanted to move, but I also moved all the notes that come after it as well. So now all those other notes are going to be out of sync with everything else. So I'm just going to undo that. And if I remove this marker just by double clicking on it, now if I hover below the note, so first I clicked above, now if I click below, now it'll actually give me three markers. So it gives me one before my note and one after. So now if I click and drag, I can change where this one note is, but the notes before it and after it remain at their original position. So that's something to watch out for when you start moving notes around, is you likely don't want to move the notes that come before it and after it. So I'm just going to undo that by, again, double clicking, and that's going to remove that marker there and put the note back to its original position. Now let's just take a quick listen at this bass. So this is before. And just to demonstrate the stretching capabilities, let's just move this note up a little bit. So you can hear that does a good job of not altering the way the note actually sounds. It's just moving it rhythmically. So that's the monophonic algorithm. Now let's move on to the next one, which is slicing. So slicing is going to be best used for drums and percussive instruments. So let's go find our drums. So here are all our drum tracks. And why the slicing algorithm is best for the drums is it acts a little bit differently than the other algorithms. So rather than lengthening and compressing notes, it actually just chops them up and moves them around and then fills in the gaps from there. So because of that, if you move your snare hit, for example, the way that snare hit sounds, the crack of the snare, if I moved it earlier, for example, it's not going to lengthen that hit and make it more drawn out. It's going to keep it nice and punchy that way. So that's why the slicing is preferred for the drums. One thing to keep in mind when you're quantizing drums is you're likely going to be dealing with more than one track. So you want to make sure that you group your tracks together so that when I move one kick, for example, it's going to move them all and all the other mics are going to move with it. I'll make sure to do a full video on how to do drum editing using the slicing flex time feature. So if we take a quick listen to these drums before. And then let's go ahead and quantize these. So go to our regions, quantize. Let's go with 8 notes. And you can see how some things have shifted around, and let's take a listen again. So you can hear once again that everything was nicely preserved and the drums still sound nice and clean. Now let's move on to the next algorithm. Now the next algorithm is rhythmic. And you might think that rhythmic would be good for drums and percussion as well, which it is and it isn't. I find that the slicing does a much cleaner job for drums than rhythmic. And the rhythmic algorithm is supposed to be used a little bit more for more repeating patterns, like maybe some strum guitar, which is just kind of the same pattern over and over. However, I've found that the rhythmic mode usually sounds a little bit phasey. And so for drums and rhythmic stuff, I'll usually use slicing. And for things like guitar, I'll usually use polyphonic. So to be honest, I don't use the rhythmic function all that much, because I find the other ones usually sound better. So with that in mind, let's look at the polyphonic one, which, as the name suggests, you'd use this for polyphonic instruments, so more chordal instruments. So for example, our acoustic guitar. So let's take a look at that. So here's our acoustic guitar. We'll set that to polyphonic. Take a quick listen to that. And we can do the same thing again. We can set our quantize value to, let's try 8th notes. And you can see how that shifted around, and let's have a listen to that. So still nice and clean. Now, next up, we have speed. Now, with all the other algorithms, the pitch never changes whether or not we shorten or lengthen a note. With the speed, however, the pitch will change. So this will be more of a creative effect rather than just simply fixing a timing. So for example, if we have this guitar and we change this to speed, and if we listen back to the same part, you'll hear that the pitch is going to shift and it's just not going to sound all that great. So that's likely not what we're going for in this song, but you can do some cool creative things with it. Now, the last one is Tempophone. And this, again, is going to be more of a creative tool rather than a timing thing. So Tempophone, this is going to emulate old tape-based time stretching. So you're going to get a lot of artifacts, and it's not going to be a nice and clean tempo stretch like you do with the other algorithms. So again, we'll listen to the same guitar part and see what that sounds like. So again, not all that clean, but you might find some creative applications to use the Tempophone algorithm. And then the last one we have at the very top, this is the flex pitch. And this would be for vocals to fix the pitch and do some tuning work. Now, I'll make sure to make a full video on flex pitch as it's a pretty in-depth topic. So I hope that helps you understand the different flex time algorithms and when to use each one on which instruments. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave those in the comments. And if you want to improve your workflow in Logic Pro, don't forget to download my free Logic Pro hotkey cheat sheet by following the link in the description below. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you in the next one.